Gary's upset because he said good morning to a lady and she told him not to talk to him. Standing up here kind of high so that I'm not hitting bottom every time I come through. I mean, I want it to be like right above a weed line, right above the grass anyway. Something like that's not going to bother me. By the way, this is the Lose Mach Smash that I'm using. It's a nice 8 bearing system. And this one, the reel was old. The reel was like maybe 3 years old. The rod is, I just got the a new rod for it over the summer because the end had worn grooves in the rod tip. Lou said it was probably a defective rod tip. But it's stainless steel tips, or stainless steel inserts, rather. In the eyes, and I'd prefer them to be ceramic for the money that I paid for, you know, for the rod and reel combo when I first got it. That was December 2019 I got the combo. So it shouldn't have done that, but I used braid on it, and after I used braid, I found out that I had the grooves. So I took it back, of course, and Shields was cool enough to replace it. It would have cost me $20 shipping if I would have sent it back to Lou's themselves, but Shields just replaced the rod for me. Been a good rod and reel. I've caught 5-pounders on it. No problem at all. Held up pretty good. The only problem I've had with it is that, like I said, that rod tip and getting the grooves. So we'll see if this one does the same thing. I mean, I'm really not complaining. Just let you all know if you buy one that they do have stainless steel inserts. And if you pay maybe $20 more, maybe $30. Right now these are $150. So if you pay a few dollars more and get the Mach 1, it's got ceramic inserts. And that I don't understand. I think there's about a $20 or $30 difference in price. Not really, you know. I just think they should put ceramic inserts in anything like that. My American Hero done the same thing. I've used it quite a bit. You've seen it in quite a few videos. And I was fishing with Gary one day and I noticed I had a bunch of frayed line, and I looked at my rod tip and sure enough, same thing, had grooves in the rod tip. So, you know, maybe if Lou sees this video, they'll see that they got a problem with their stainless steel tips and put ceramic in anything that's, you know, that they sell. reason I'm pinpointing right here, as I was telling Jerry, well, you probably can't see it with the camera, but if you were able to walk, if there was no water, you could walk right out to about right straight out there. And that point, it's like a peninsula, a point, sandbar, so to speak, there's an 11-foot drop-off when the water is at full capacity. So now it's probably about a 6 or 8. And that's where I've caught all my big fish during the summertime, is off of that drop-off. So I'm focusing on just a little past where the drop-off would be. And right now it doesn't seem like it's too deep. See very little activity today. I figured, you know, we've had some 50 degree weather nights, so I figured it'd be some pretty good fishing. So far, it's just not. That doesn't mean it's not gonna be. December 23rd, so it's probably one of the last fishing days that we'll have. But at the, you know, I think I'm gonna go to a Texas rig worm or something. I don't know. I don't think a moving bait is gonna work. I could be wrong. I could be wrong. Maybe go back to the jerk bait and stand up here so that I don't have to worry about it going so deeply again. But then again, that little pocket down there is pretty inviting too right now, so maybe I can go down there and catch a bass. I'm just trying to catch a fish today for you guys. It's been a couple of weeks since I've caught one. I really don't want to try to catch a fish off of the dock. A little high to be lifting one up. Thought I had a bite. Sure felt like it, but it might have been weeds. There are some weeds out here. I think she's packing up my stuff too. Oops. Oh no, you just wanted to use my tackle box. You just wanted to use my tackle box to sit on, that's all. This Mach smash, by the way, will cast a mile.